Beautiful day to go on an errand. I have to sort out a lighting issue on the car, which entails a trip across town to a Volkswagen specialist. And on a lovely day like this, I'll come the pretty way and ride a nice bike. The Gazelle Cheetah, the big bronze gazelle. However, let's not forget we're in England, so of course it's not going to be quite so idyllic, is it? These kissing gates are not made for Dutch bikes. There's another one going towards the hospital. Picnic areas full of people. Maybe they turned up for the zoo to find it's not open. I think she was actually waiting for me. Blackpool Zoo, the old aircraft hangars from the Second World War, Stanley Park Aerodrome and Wellington Bomber Factory. Takes no prisoners, this bell. This bell definitely says, I'm coming through. Lake of Stanley Park beyond the fence. And for the bike geeks there, you just saw me using the Sturmey Archer 3-speed shifter there, but it's one of the modern type. And it's lovely, I really like it. Cross the road and come into the park now. I couldn't video that because there's a traffic crossing involved. As it's so rammed this way, I think I'll go around the back way in the park. Yeah, this Sturmey shifter, I've just used it again there. The reason I've got that on this bike is because the size of this bike, it needed a cable longer than you can normally get readily anyway, as a Sturmey Archer shifter cable with its unique nipple on the end, like a sleeve nipple. It needed really a cable longer than that. This shifter uses a standard gear cable, a universal one with a pear nipple. So I was able to get a nice long cable run. They're good for tandems, for that reason you can use a tandem gear cable for an extra long run. It's part of what I like so much about this bike is that I've tweaked everything to the nth degree on this one. Sorry about that. I've tweaked everything on it to such a degree that it is so, to use that expression, dialed in. Exactly how I like it. It's tuned to perfection in my taste. If ever I play that fantasy game that I'm sure some of us play, with money no object, what would I do to my bikes? When I come to this one, I can't find anything to do. I had to do a quick hand swap there. If I think money no object, what would I do to this bike? There's only one thing needs doing, and that's free. That's change the right hand crank. It's looking a little scruffy for some reason, so let's just pop another one on, which I have. It's absolutely perfect for me, really. And I also say in that other game of if you could only save one bike, which would it be? It's always either this or my Bob Jackson, because my Bob Jackson was made for me and I'm attached to it in that way. Another 60 centimetre frame in dark bronze metallic, just as it happens. That is coincidence. But thinking properly about it, I could get the Bob Jackson made again. I could go back to BJ's and they would just make the same thing exactly the same for me. And I'd just put the same bits on it.
Thank you.
So really that makes it this one. Because this is irreplaceable. And I have that other Gazelle, the golden bronze one, from the same era as this one, which was brand new old stock, unridden, before I got it. So yeah, why not that one? Isn't that more irreplaceable? On paper, yes. But the thing is, with a new old stock bike, I've had this problem before. They're a bit precious. There's only so much you can change and sleep at night, or me anyway. The old Asperger's kicks in and I think, no, I can't do anything to it that I can't easily change back, like tyres and handlebar grips, where I just keep the originals. Blackpool can be quite nice, you know, really, honestly. Yeah, this bike, I have changed things quite a lot, but nothing so as you'd notice, nothing overt, apart from maybe these handlebar grips, which, like several of my bikes, are Portland Design Works whiskey grips. I get these bits and pieces when those PDW grips aren't really available in the UK. But I get them from the same place I got these shifters, which I have on several bikes. Practical Classics, no, that's a magazine. Practicalcycles.co.uk. And it's just all one word, practicalcycles.co.uk. It's a small, more or less one-man business, about 7 miles from here. He's a good chap, he's sincere, and he's excellent for Sturmey Archer stuff, Dutch bike stuff, cargo bike stuff. They are dealers in cargo bikes primarily. But they carry a lot of this kind of stuff. I think the front carrier on here, I found a Steco Dutch one, exactly the same as the one that Gazelle fitted to the rear to match it. I found that there, 8 miles, 10 miles from home. Right, as you might be able to see, we're coming to actually two, one after the other, major road junctions now. So I'm going to get through these in relative safety and see you on the other side. Rather nice factory building. I understand, correct me if I'm wrong, that was the offices of the old Duple Coachworks, which was all along this road. Duple Coachworks built a goodly proportion of the British holiday coaches. I'll have to nip into here as well. Yeah, the famous old Bedford OB Duple. It's one of the products that got them established, and many more for decades after. Port of call number one. I think they're supposed to go around and down those ramps and back up the other side and by the cattle barriers. No. See, we've got a headwind now because we're heading towards the sea. The wind always comes off the sea here. But I never go fast on this bike. Although it's an absolutely sublime bicycle to ride, it's not something I'd ever want to go fast on. It never wants to go fast. It's funny how that goes, because my bigger, slightly heavier Gazelle, the 2012 Tour Pop, does seem to like getting into its stride. This one likes to go slow. But it weighs, gosh, I don't know, somewhere in the 50s, 50 to 60 pounds this bike weighs. So it's like riding three lightweight road bikes all at the same time. And the other day when I was compiling my slideshow video about cargo bikes, I commented on how strong I was when I rode cargo bikes for a living, 6 days a week, riding 200, 250 kilos all day. The little cooperative I was part of, we had a messenger division as well, which I occasionally rode the lightweight messenger bikes, but I preferred the cargo bikes, I enjoyed them. And whenever the cargo bike riders were up against the messenger bike riders, we walked all over them. Absolutely blew them into the weeds. So I've always said that this corner off. That's the road we want going across here. I'm cutting this corner off. I've always said that people who go cycling to get fit and to train and do so by buying themselves the lightest road bike that they can, it's like going to the gym and only using the baby weights. Is what you want, something like this. Something that weighs 60 pounds and only has one or three gears. Certainly if you want to build strength and you want to build cardiovascular fitness. Pissing about on a lightweight bike, it's not going to do it half as effectively as pootling around on one of these. But of course, we all know, don't we, that there is an industry dedicated to persuading people otherwise and to selling them the expensive kit. And that industry is imbued with an awful lot of ego. The sports cycling culture is very club-based and group-based, and so the peer pressure is enormous and the judgmentalism is enormous for anyone who fails to do it exactly the same way that they are. I mean, each to their own. Nothing wrong with that. But let's make no mistake, if you're doing that to get fit, it's not going to do it as effectively. But that's just my few pence anyway. This is going to the same place as that main road.
Oh.
But doing it in a quieter way. A more interesting way as well. Because I'm a nosy parker. I love cycling through suburbs, sitting up on an upright bike, looking over garden fences and garden gates, looking over the top of the parked cars. And on this bike, eye level is here. It's amazing what you find. I've lost count of the number of times when I've been cycling through a suburban area or even a rural area, and I've ended up coming back out later to pick up something I've seen that someone's got by the gate. A case in point being about 3 weeks ago, when I stopped by a place. I've been past it 100 times. I often stop and buy eggs. I'd stopped on the Raleigh Riviera and bought eggs and ended up going back to pick up some bikes, with more to come once the virus has gone and it's safe. Right, here we are, main road into the main shopping area. I'm popping to a Halfords over the back, so I shall leave you here for the moment. So I've just been to Halfords. I never go to Halfords for bicycle parts. I needed some indicator light bulbs for the car, and that's the nearest place to get them. Because the small businesses, are mostly still shut. Seems to be special rules for the big chains. In every retail sector it seems to have been like that. Different rules for the big chains as there are for small businesses. I'm glad I don't have a small bike shop at the moment. Although, of course, bike shops are allowed to stay open, but it's fundamentally easier for the big chains with their distribution hubs and such like, and the larger premises, to be able to do that, especially when you sell car spares as well. And a lot of the smaller bike shops around here anyway have not bothered opening because it was just too difficult to put the measures in place that they needed to put in place. I can see that, I can see how that would be. But Halfords have got a table at the door, serving people from a table at the door. You can't go in the shop. It's nice. And because there was a proportion of the element that hang about in Halfords who were kicking off at not being allowed in and not being allowed to browse the stereos and the Boy Racer add-ons, and the staff were telling them we're not selling those things at the moment, and they were getting shirty because their opinion was that the lockdown has ended now and everything's back to normal, and of course that's not the case. But it seems to be a prevailing opinion among a certain element. Right, there's the park again that we cycled past earlier. We're more or less retracing our steps back now. And my waffle digressed into the very unsavoury business of far-right racists taking over Manchester Tweed Ride. So I've decided I'll save that for a separate video on that topic alone. Because the whole world probably isn't interested in that. If only you could smell the wild garlic coming up from Salisbury Woods. There's the pillbox memorial. I'm not going to go into that today because I showed you in a previous ride. If you scroll down my channel, you'll see a video with a windmill on the front cover. Something about a sunny ramble on the hopper or something like that. That's where I go into the old airfield here and the Wellington Bomber Factory, and we go down the path to that pillbox and have a look at it. What have we got here? Shared use just does not work. That's not disparaging the people at all who are just out for a walk. It's the concept of shared use we go through this little housing development and then it's main roads. So I'm going to leave you here as I pant up this hill in first gear. Places I need to park in the sunshine. Massive kickstands on Gazelles. That's from a Gazelle of the 2000s. It's a wonderfully wide kickstand. There is what I suppose earlier I made my official favourite bike. A circa 1980 Gazelle Cheetah. 60cm seat tube, 60cm top tube, same as my Bob Jackson. Very laid back angles, unlike my Bob Jackson. 28-inch wheels. Sturmey Archer 3-speed, drum brakes, dynamo lighting. But that's only the spec. The spec can't get across the charm of the thing. Never felt embarrassingly conspicuous when you're making a video. That's not why I ride bikes like this. Compliments from people who know bikes is nice, but I'm not someone who does things for compliments or take compliments easily, really. I do this to take myself into my happy place. There's my happy place there. Hopefully we'll have a 3-speed October this year. Fingers crossed. Although the 3-speed October does emanate from the US and is participated in by some of us here in Britain, so we are rather lagging behind the world in terms of getting rid of the virus. So let's see. Let's hope that we're seeing the end of it. I'm hoping against my own thoughts here, but until next time, stay safe.